Okay, friends, today we are going to discuss about the metallurgy. We are discussing about metallurgy. Okay, students, let's start about some discussion regarding. Before I am going to discuss about Erlangen diagram. I will recollect the what are the topics we discussed previously. So first of all, remember one first point is then extraction of a crude metal from its concentrated ore only. Then in this one concept is there now, whatever the metal ore is there now, we want convert into oxide ore first. That oxide ore further reduced by the reducing agent to form a metal zone. In these two steps, we are going to discuss in detail in this concept. Later, I am going to discuss about the how pyrometallurgy, but heat is applied for the reduction of metals. It means generally all metal oxides cannot reduce easily. So, by using some external condition, we can reduce the metal oxide into metal only. So, which metal oxide at what temperature it can reduce a particular metal oxide? Okay, just imagine the concern the zinc oxide is reduced easily. Okay, by using of carbon. For reduction of the iron oxide, we need the more amount of carbon oxide. And this happens nearly above the 1000 Kelvin's temperature. So what temperature the reduction process happen and what are the factors which influence the reduction process, we'll discuss in detail only. Clear? So first I'm discussing about the conversion into oxides, so you know very well. One simple recap is there. So remember here, the conversion into oxide means now generally we are carrying the calcination process. Calcination involves nothing but heating up the metal ore, okay, in the little supply of the oxygen. What happened there? Carbonate ores have become to the oxide ore. Here also carbonate ore has become to the oxide ore is there, no? Then hydrate ore has become to the anhydrate ore. Clear? What are the processes? The calcination, during the calcination process, volatile gas will be escapes. Volatile materials are there, no? All volatile materials will be escapes. Okay, next one is roasting process there. You know very well roasting process. In this roasting process, metals are heated with supply X amount of air. Okay, no? When you have heated X amount of air, what happens? They generally zinc sulfide is when react with oxygen, they form a zinc oxide plus sulfur dioxide. Whatever the roasting or calcination process, then the main role is the conversion of the metal ore into metal oxides only. Clear? One small point remember here, they given the copper sulfate plus oxygen is there now. Copper sulfate contain impurities, iron oxide. Both they have similar properties are there. So I want to remove the iron particles are there, iron impurities is there now. I will add some external material, silicon dioxide. Silicon dioxide only form a complex with iron oxide and the form a slag. This metal, this slag is there now, both will be not mix. We can separate by the filtration method. If generally the different filtration method applied in the metallurgy process. And next one is the reduction of the oxide of the metals only. Generally this one is the reduction after by the previous method, either calcination, roasting, we convert the metal ore into oxide ore only. That oxide I want convert into metal, pure metal form only. Reduction of the metal oxide usually involves the heating of its with some reducing agent. I'm using either carbon is reducing agent or carbon oxide is reducing agent. Any two reducing agents, any one reducing agent you can use. But this reducing agent is specified for particular metal. This reducing agent is specified for particular metal oxides only. So which is the best one is they explained by the Erlangen diagram, thermodynamics. These two criteria will help us which metal oxide is best reducing agent and what temperature these reactions happen. What are the necessary conditions you must take care before the reduction of metal oxide. Clear? Some metal oxides get reduced easily while other very difficult to be reduced. I said very clearly, you know, some metal oxides are easily reduced. Suppose I'm just taking the copper oxide, silver oxide, which is there, you know, these metal oxides are easily reduced. They undergo self-reduction process. Self-reduction process means themselves they will convert into pure metals on heating process. Next, remaining iron oxide is there, iron oxide, aluminum oxide is there, they are very difficult to reduce only. So what happened there, in any cases, heating is required. Generally for reduction of high reactive metal, moderate reactive metals, heating is required. In order to understand the heating, how much heat is required is then explained by the pyrometallurgy concept. The pyrometallurgy concept gives idea at what temperature by using the what reducing agent and what reduction is happened. Clear? Next one is the thermodynamics. For suppose you know very well some metal oxide is there. I can use the more reactive metal also to reduce the metal oxides only. If you want to study that one is there, remember that concept is called aluminum thermite process. Doing you know very well aluminum thermite process, they for the reduction of the iron, they will use the small amount of the magnesium oxide. Magnesium they will use. Okay, no? Now just remember for that whatever they are considered most reactive metals, you just consider like displacement reactions. Here metal oxide react with metal, displacement reaction happen, our oxygen will be exchanged only. So for that one is which metal is reduced very better, given by the Gibbs free energy. Gibbs free energy. So students, let's have very clear detail regarding this concept. Okay, next one, very very important, thermodynamic principles of metallurgy. In the previous class we discussed about the thermodynamics, Gibbs free energy, entropy value, enthalpy change. Clear? So in this session we are applying the thermodynamics concept in order to extract a particular metal. How thermodynamic concept will give us idea at what temperature, by which method, which metal is best to use. The extraction of a metal from their oxide by using a particular reducing agent can be predicted by thermodynamics only. Do you know very well, thermodynamics process will give us idea which reducing agent can reduce more economically, profitably, you know, which reducing agent is preferred as used by the thermodynamics concept. Which element reduce particular metal oxide at specific temperature? Explain metallurgy. Okay, at specific temperature, which metal is better reducing agent? You know very well, for zinc oxide reduction is there, you need the carbon only. The temperature is 673 Kelvin is there. For copper oxide is there, we need carbon, 1000 degrees Celsius. Both difference is there, Oh, students, once again note down here. Zinc oxide for reduction process by using of carbon, it's required 673 Kelvin temperature. Copper oxide also reduced with carbon, but it required 1000 Kelvin temperature. For iron oxide reduction is required, iron oxide, carbon monoxide, its temperature is 400 to 1500 Kelvin. How are saying this, which one is best reducing agent, means by using of this concept only. So I will explain very clearly. For spontaneous chemical reaction changes is there. Look at this, whenever any chemical reaction will want occur, Gibbs free energy value is negative. Gibbs free energy value is negative, then it is called as a spontaneous chemical reaction. Gibbs free energy is equal to minus spontaneous reaction. Look, Gibbs free energy value is negative, then its reaction is called as a spontaneous chemical reaction. Gibbs free energy value is positive, then reaction is called as a non-spontaneous chemical reaction. Non-spontaneous chemical reaction means that chemical reaction is never takes place in reality. Spontaneous chemical reaction means, like, but just consider I'm just taking the sodium and I place in the air, itself it burns. Itself it is burning means spontaneous reactions. Suppose if the Gibbs free energy change value is coming is negative, that reaction is both forward reaction, backward reaction takes place simultaneously. It clearly indicates that reaction is there in the, that reaction in the equilibrium positions only. So let's have some detail regarding this one. Is there students, first you have to understand the basic terminology is there, Delta G stands for Gibbs, change in the Gibbs free energy only. Change in the Gibbs free energy. Delta H nothing but way, exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction can explain based on Delta H and enthalpy change. Delta H is called enthalpy change. For exothermic reaction, this Delta H value is negative will come. For endothermic reaction, Delta H value is positive will come. Delta S nothing but entropy change. Okay, no? Entropy change. What is entropy change? Nothing but after chemical reaction, the product is gas, enter Delta S value is positive. After chemical reaction, compound is solid, product is solid, Delta S value is negative. Gibbs free energy change value depend upon the Delta S only. This Delta S value is multiplication of temperature only. So multiplication of temperature is there, So what happens when temperature increases, Delta S value increases. So Gibbs free energy value is decreases only. Gibbs free energy value decreases only. Next one is very very important one is Gibbs free energy value also can be calculated by using of the chemical equilibrium also. Do you know chemical equilibrium is there, Delta G is equal to minus RT ln K. Delta G is equal to minus RT ln K. K stands for equilibrium constant. K stands for equilibrium constant. This is nothing but a product minus reactant, you can just consider it. R stands for universal gas constant. T stands for absolute temperature. T stands for absolute temperature. So in this both chemical reactions are there. One point remember, this concept, why we are taking this chemical equilibrium concept means, Ellingham diagram has given idea based on the reduction of the metal oxides. Both forward reactions and backward reactions are takes place. That's why this concept is applied. Clear? Okay, remember students, I'll give small example, you'll get very clear idea. So once again, look at this one, thermodynamic spontaneous chemical reaction is there, That one is Delta G stands for change in the Gibbs free energy value. delta H stands for change in the enthalpy. Enthalpy value delta has nothing but a change in the entropy value. Okay, whether the gas is forming or solid is forming, it decides only at what temperature it is forming. Okay, at what temperature is forming? Students, this is very, very important. Just imagine here. Suppose I'm taking the one metal, it is a solid. Here oxygen is gas. Okay, here oxygen is a gas only. Whenever any material is gaseous state, means no, entropy value is positive for gas material. For solid is then entropy value is negative only. But a metal react with oxygen, they form metal oxide. It means gas is reactant become a solid product. So what happened there? Entropy value is negative. Entropy value is negative. Do you know all combustion reactions are exothermic reactions? One point number, all combustion reactions are exothermic reaction. So the change in the enthalpy value is negative. So this idea I'm applying the thermodynamics equation. Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. Enthalpy value is negative only, no? Exothermic reactions only, no? That's why mentioned minus value. Minus temperature mentioned standard condition. And delta S value. Delta S means here what happens? Gas becomes solid. Gas becomes solid, entropy value is negative only, negative only. It's clear here, so whenever temperature increases, look at what happens, just consider delta G value will be decrease only. At high temperature, delta G becomes positive. Why becomes positive? Minus into minus plus will come, no? If temperature increases, what happens there? That becomes minus, becomes positive. The positive becomes, you know, the total change in Gibbs energy value is positive. So at high temperature, one, that's also remember one concept is there, no? According to Lee-Chatelier principle, if any reaction, exothermic reaction, if we increase temperature, the reaction will go backward direction. That's the reason why this reaction occurs at the low temperature. At low temperature, Gibbs free energy value is negative. One point remember, if any chemical reaction gives a free energy value more negative, more feasible. I'll give a small example. Suppose look at there, a metal react with oxygen, metal oxide zone, you know. If you take a car, you just consider if you take a silver, react with oxygen from silver oxide, you know, the delta G value is minus 10. If you take sodium, the delta G value is minus 1000. So which one more negative value is? And sodium. So what happens? Sodium reactions are more feasible will be there. Okay, sodium reactions are more feasible. I'll give a small example to get very clear. Carbon solid react with oxygen from carbon monoxide only. Initial carbon is solid. Means here entropy value is there, no, negative. Gas entropy value positive. After the chemical reaction, the product is gases form. Gases form means entropy value is increasing. And this value is positive. This value is positive is when you increase temperature, more reaction will be possible. Okay, no? Increased temperature. Look at that, just consider it at a high temperature. Okay, no? High temperature is there, the reaction is more possible one. Okay, no? Delta G increases with increasing temperature only. Clear one, the if suppose one point I will say very clearly, if the product is a gas, increase temperature. Product is a solid, decrease temperature. That's his basic idea. Next example I will take here. Suppose I'm taking the carbon solid, react with oxygen from carbon dioxide. What happens if the 1 mole of oxygen gives 1 mole of gas, 1 mole of gas giving 1 mole of gas. So the change in the delta S value is zero. The change in delta S value is zero. Changing delta S value zero means no, Gibbs free energy value does not depend upon the delta S value. Okay, no? It is not depend upon the temperature. It's not depend upon the temperature. So for delta S value T into zero, zero only, no? So product value is becoming to zero. So for these kind of reactions are there, no? These kind of reactions, the change in the Gibbs free energy value is there, no, does not depend upon the entropy. Once again, I am saying very clearly. Look at your students, this is a thermodynamic equation. Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. Delta S nothing but change in the entropy. Nothing but gas become liquid, liquid become solid, solid become gas. Everything we explain the delta S only. Delta H explain about the exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. These two summation values, then a subtraction value you can consider, as that's nothing but a Gibbs free energy value. Delta G value is negative, that reaction is possible easily. Delta G value positive, that reaction will not happen. Delta G is equal to zero, that reaction is in equilibrium position. Suppose look at the metal solid react with oxygen, they form metal oxide solid. So what when they're solid forming means delta S value decreases. Delta S value is decreasing means temperature must be low temperature. Suppose look at some other equation here. Product is forming gas. Gas forming means delta S value increase. Delta S value positive, increase temperature, the reaction happen more. So look at the number of moles of gas react product reactant, gases reactant and gas products are same. So delta S value is not dependent upon the temperature. This is nothing but a temperature Gibbs free energy value. How will give you idea about the whether reaction are feasible or not, whether reaction are feasible or not. Okay, students, look at here. This one is condition. Look at the one example I give. The metal oxide is there. No? The metal oxides are more stable. Only. After reduction, metal oxide become metal. This is unstable. So these kind of chemical reactions are not possible. Metal oxide is stable. Reaction will not happen. So metal is formed. Metal is more reactive. Only again will come in. So if product is stable, then only reaction happen only. Carbon monoxide is stable. Look at the reaction happen when no carbon monoxide is happen. Look at I want very clearly. Suppose look at the for reduction of this process is not happen. Suppose I'm just taking two conditions in there. Metal oxide to metal. I calculate Gibbs free energy value is coming is positive. Carbon solid to carbon monoxide. Gibbs free energy value is coming negative. When you combine both this value, if the total change in the Gibbs free energy value, one is the no, reduction, second one is oxidation. Both Gibbs free energy values become no total Gibbs free energy value is negative. Then its reaction is called as a feasible reaction. Clear? Feasible reaction, sorry. Look at students, the metal solid react with oxygen, the form metal oxide is a gas. Gas forming is not when the entropy value is increases, the reaction happen feasible. Look at if a chemical complex is then Gibbs free energy value is negative, then reaction is called as a spontaneous chemical reaction. Sorry. Okay, then students say the most important whatever we are discussing Gibbs free energy value, entropy values increases, decreases, everything will be applied in the Ellinger diagram. Very, very important for your IIT examination, NEET examination. Features of Ellinger diagram. Okay, let's have give small idea. Ellinger diagram, nothing but the scientist is Ellinger has given when how look at the metal oxide of formation metal oxide value, how changes Gibbs free energy value with respect to temperature. Clear everything one by one point I will explain. Observe, listen carefully. The feature of Ellinger diagram. First one is the graph of the formation of metal oxide is a straight line with an upward slope only. Look at there, whatever the formation look at magnesium react with oxygen for metal oxide. How this graph is moving? Graph is moving upward direction. Suppose aluminum react with oxygen from aluminum oxide. How is coming? The graph is also moving in the upward direction. Clear. Similarly, here also look at the icons just considered zinc is forming the zinc oxide. The graph is moving upward direction. So whatever the metal oxides are forming, they are up in the straight wall. Look at one point, remember here metal is contain more negative value. After formation metal oxide value is then look at the delta G value is decreases only. Means more reactive metal becomes less reactive metal oxides. Clear? Next one point is there here the features of Ellinger diagram. Next point is there now. There is a sudden change in the slope for some metal oxides only. Remember one point, sudden change in slope is look at this one is two conditions are there. No? When our metal oxide forming up to the particular temperature, just imagine I'm taking this one is a 1300 Kelvin's temperature. Above this temperature, what happens is sudden slope change is decreases is there, no? Nothing but here some bendings happen. Why is bending happen? Means no? After this temperature, metal oxide becomes a liquid state and again from the liquid is easily reduced. That's only there is a sudden change in the slope only. Look at there is a sudden change in the slope for some metal oxide like magnesium oxide, zinc oxide, mercury oxide. It means here these oxide on applying high temperature they become liquid only. They can easily reduce only. For few metal oxides are mercury and silver, the graph is upper part of the Ellinger diagram. Here very, very important. I said one point is there now. Look at there, yeah, just consider this is G, delta G value is negative, 0, delta G value is 0. Look at there, when our mercury oxide is forming, when increased temperature, mercury oxide is forming, no? When increase general increase temperature, mercury oxide approaches positive value. Whenever approaching positive value means, mercury oxide at high temperature is unstable. It decomposes into mercury plus oxygen. Similar way, silver oxide is then at high temperature unstable. It becomes a silver plus oxide. Because whenever negative value, more negative value is the more stable oxide is there. Positive value means less stable oxide is there. I will say one side, another example is. Next one is then here the graph is upper part of the Ellinger diagram only. So next one is the look at here. This one is then fourth point is then the graph of the for the formation of carbon monoxide is straight line with negative slope only. Look at a formation of carbon monoxide is the more negative value. It means when compared with carbon, carbon monoxide is more stable. So what when the slope is coming, negative slope is coming. This is very very important. We are applying thermodynamics for iron reduction. So formation of carbon monoxide is more negative value with increased temperature. So it means if at high temperature it acts as best reducing agent carbon monoxide when compared with carbon. The graph of for the formation of CO2 is straight line, okay, parallel to the temperature axis. Because formation of carbon dioxide is the formation of carbon dioxide is straight line. It means here there is no change in the reduction process if you increase temperature or decrease temperature. There is no significant role of the carbon dioxide for reduction process according to the Ellingen diagram. Clear? In this room, one point remember when compared with carbon and carbon monoxide, the best reducing agent means carbon monoxide. Why is best reducing agent? Delta G value is negative. Delta G value is negative, more feasible will be there. More feasible will be the reaction possible, takes plus higher value. Next one is remember here the significance of the Ellingen diagram only. The positive slope of a metal oxide shows that stability decreases with increasing temperature. Clear? Look at it, just consider this the decrease in the stability of is due to the increasing delta G value. Look at it, the whenever delta G value, look at it, stability is decreased. Clear? Stability is decreased only. Okay? Look at the positive slope means when I increase the temperature, the stability of metal oxides are decreases. That's the idea. This is temperature, the tense temperature here gives green energy. Clear on instruments here. So next one is the point, look at the next one is the okay, second point is the sudden change in the graph. Look at the sudden change in the graph. You can shows as a phase changes of solid to liquid or liquid to vapor. Means it becomes liquid to vapor. One point I want to be clear. I have the liquid, I have the solid, liquid gas, which can reduce easily. Means gas. Next one is liquid only. That's one way. The negative slope of C carbon monoxide shows that it becomes more stable with increasing temperature. I said very clearly, no? It becomes more stable with increasing temperature only. Okay. Here, look at this one. One point is there. No significance of the Ellingen diagram. Fourth point is not. The tendency of formation of metal oxide to metal oxide metal to look at the fourth point is the tendency of the metal oxide. Remember also very clearly the stability of metal oxides only. Stability of metal oxide. If I have magnesium burns easily when compared with silver. So nothing more reactive metals. Next aluminum, next zinc, iron, mercury and silver. Suppose silver oxide is there, no? If you add mercury oxide from silver will copy. This is due to the increase in the negative delta G is the formation of oxides only. Nothing but here the more easily magnesium oxide will form. Suppose it's considered aluminum thermate process, then if you take aluminum oxide, when you add magnesium powder, here what happens, magnesium takes oxygen from the aluminum. The aluminum forms a metal, magnesium form metal oxides only. This metal is more reactive metal, this can displace oxygen from here. Okay, the Ellingen graph explains the formation of different metal oxides with respect to change in delta G value. Okay, delta G value. Students, here the next one, last point is there, no? Importance of the Ellingen diagrams only. What the Ellingen diagrams is explain about that, but here, look at the magnesium oxide, which appears below the graph of the aluminum is there, no? It can reduce aluminum. Aluminum can reduce zinc. Clear? Zinc can reduce mercury. Mercury can reduce silver. This easily explained without calculation, explain the Ellingen diagram only. So remember one point is in a silver oxide, mercury oxide can be easily decomposed at temperature of 600 Kelvin, 100 Kelvin. I said very clear, no? Whenever metal oxide graph is moving above this zero line is there, no? These oxides are unstable. Next one is the no? Aluminum oxide is reduced by magnesium. I said very clearly, magnesium can reduce aluminum. Okay? Next one is last point is the look at the you consider, suppose you consider the iron oxide, I am just taking carbon, at 900 Kelvin is there, they form iron plus carbon dioxide is coming. So at what temperature this reduction happen, Ellingen diagram explains. Clear? So look at the area, just consider at what temperature reductions happen, at Ellingen diagram explains. At low temperature, CO is the better reducing agent. I said very clear, no? At low temperature, CO is carbon monoxide is better reducing agent. Better reducing agent. So this is regarding the Ellingen diagrams only. Students, as I will say, some important features of Ellingen diagram, some drawbacks of Ellingen diagram. What is drawback of Ellingen diagram means? The Ellingen diagram, okay, students, limitations of Ellingen diagram. Ellingen diagram
only gives idea about the thermodynamic and physical, or the chemical reaction happen or not by applying heat only explain. It doesn't discuss about the chemical kinetics of the, whether reaction is fast or speed. The reaction fast or speed is never explained thermodynamics only. He has taken the thermodynamic equation is chemical equilibrium. I said not delta G is equal to minus RT ln K. These kind of equilibrium reactions are not generally takes place in the metallurgy only. Clear students, this is regarding the Ellingen diagram, very very important. Okay students, I will be recollect one small idea. Okay, Ellingen diagrams gives idea when our metal oxide is forming, delta G value decreases or increases only. Next one is it explain about the whether the metal oxide after formation of metal oxides, okay, no, whether delta G value increases or positive. Next one is there know whether metal oxides are stable or not at high temperature. Metal oxide stable or not at high temperature cannot explain by the Ellingen diagram. Next one is then which metal can reduce other metals at what temperature? Explain the Ellingen diagram. At above that what temperature, which metal, suppose look at that low temperature, the reduction of metal oxide is not easily. At high temperature, reduction of metal oxides are very easy only. At what temperature reduction is happen easily? Explain the Ellingen diagram. When Ellingen diagram also gives idea about the carbon monoxide better reducing agent or carbon dioxide better reducing agent. Carbon monoxide better reducing agent at low temperature. Okay, they also given the Ellingen diagram. So nothing but this guy gave one graph. By based on this graph, is without doing any calculation, we can simply is giving idea only. He has given one guidelines. If follow for these guidelines, you can reduce metal easily. Nothing but this was the Ellingen diagram. This is regarding Ellingen diagram.